Thousands turn out to mourn the loss of four Manheim Central students. It's our top story in the first 11 at 11. All of the 2,500 seats in the LCBC church were filled as an overflow crowd came out for the last public memorial service for the students. The mother of one of the teenage victims talked about her son for the first time since the crash. News 8's Matt Barcarroll was there.
On a night like this, talking about football seems so insignificant. But football is how the Manheim Central community got to know these young men. Their teammates, proudly wearing their Barons jerseys, ushered in their caskets.
Baron Nation has lost four of its favorite sons.
And their coach gave the final eulogy.
These boys are examples of the kind of players in Manheim that would allow someone like myself to be a head coach for 30 years. They cannot be replaced.
15-year-old Devon Lee, a freshman standout on the team, an incredible listener, hard worker, and pampered son.
God is helping us with the pain, which is relentless right now. But because you are in heaven, we will try to make this world a better place till we see you again.
16-year-old Cody Hollinger, a sophomore, already captain of the swim team and always competitive, even when hunting.
Two ducks went over, five guys shot, two ducks fell, and his Uncle John looked at him and said, "Do you think you hit any?" He said, "What do you mean? I shot both of those."
15-year-old Nicholas Bryson, a sophomore who had both a knack for finances and a soft side.
While he loved hunting, he would not hunt deer. He said their eyes were too big and too pretty to shoot deer.
And 16-year-old John Griffith, a singer in the shower, despite poor reviews from his older brother.
I love you, John. We all love you, and we shall be with you again one day. Rest easy and fly high.
They'll be happy to be.
Their lasting memories to many are those they made on the field. But what pains these mourners the most is not knowing what more their legacies could have been. Matt Barcaro, News 8.
Three of the teens will be laid to rest tomorrow. Nicholas Bryson's funeral is on Sunday.